third chapter, that is singular and plural. Okay, so let's start. Now, what is basically a singular noun and plural noun? Okay, we will learn about them one by one. Now, in singular noun, it is done that it names one person, place, thing, or idea. Okay, it names one person, place, thing, or an idea. Okay, for example, Kavi. Okay, now this person Kavi refers to a single unit, a singular person. Likewise, Delhi represents to a single city. Likewise, chair. Chair is comes under the category of an object or a thing. So it denotes a unit quantity, means a singular unit, that is singular, this chair. Okay, so the both all of them comes under the category of singular noun. Okay, now next we come to the plural noun. Now it names more than one person, place, thing, or idea. Okay, what it names more than one person, place, thing, or an idea. Right? You can see here, for example, boys. Okay, now boys, what boys represent? More than one boy. Okay, more than one means plural. Likewise, cities. Okay, means more than one city. If we will talk about city, it is singular noun. Now city is a plural, mean more than one city. Likewise, decks. Okay, mean more than one desk. Okay, so they come under the category of plural noun. Okay, now you are clear about singular noun and plural noun. Okay, now children, we will learn about how we can change singular nouns to plural ones. Okay, let us look at this first one. Most plural nouns are formed by adding s after the word. For example, tree. Tree is a singular noun, a single unit, a single tree. When s is added to this word, it becomes trees. Trees means more than one tree. It becomes singular to plural. Okay, likewise, cave. Cave means single cave. Okay, singular noun. When s is added to this noun, it becomes caves. Caves means more than one cave, plural noun. Okay, come to second one. If a noun ends with y, means the letter y, it takes ies to become a plural. Then what happens? Y is removed. The last letter y from the word is removed and ies is added to the word to become plural. Okay, like for example, we can see here factory. In this word factory, the last letter is y, and factory is a singular unit, a single one, represent a singular unit. Okay, so now in its singular form, it is having this last letter as y. Now when we transfer it or change it to its plural form, what happens? We just remove y from here and add ies to this word, then it becomes factories. And factories, what does this word represent? More than one factory, a plural noun. Come to the third point. Most singular nouns ending in f, okay, f or fe, change to ves in the plural. Means the nouns, the singular nouns which are having f or fe as their last letters. Okay, like for example, you can see this word knife. Okay, so this word ends with the letter, two letter we can see here, f and e, fe. Okay, this singular noun ends with these letters fe. Okay, and when we transfer or change it into the plural noun. What we do? We just remove this fe from this word and add ves in the end. Okay, we just remove fe and add the ves, and that it becomes knives, means more than one knife. That is a plural noun. Okay, now there's example of this f, thief. Now what is a thief? Thief represent a singular noun. Now when, and it also end, the last letter of this word is f. So when we change it into the plural noun, then it becomes thieves. Okay, we just remove this f from here and thus add ves, then it transfers or it is changed into singular noun to plural noun, like this. Okay, fourth one we can see here, there are some rare plurals, means there are some rare plurals. How we can see, for example, children. Now child, what is this word child? It represents a singular noun, and when ren is added to it, then it becomes children. That is a plural noun. Likewise, ox. Ox represents a singular noun, single ox, and when en is added to that ox, then it becomes plural, means more than one ox. Okay, so these are few rules how we can change singular noun to plural nouns. Okay, there are more rules I have given in the notes. Okay, you can get it from there. Okay, that's all for this chapter. Thank you.